Slide background has a huge impact on the look and feel of your presentation. In ActivePresenter, you can use background fill, background image, background styles, and slide master to control over your background design. Using the background fill section of the slide properties tab in the properties pane, you can change the slide background with a solid or gradient color, or an image. To apply a solid color to slide background, select solid fill, click color, and choose the color you want. If you cannot find your favorite color from the list, click this button to create custom colors. Otherwise, use eyedropper to sample any color of objects and apply it to the slide background. Change the opacity level of the background here if needed. If you don't want to show background objects, hide them by ticking this checkbox. Then, you can choose to apply to all slides, or revert to the original one. Apart from solid fill, gradient fill helps you fill the selected slides with a gradient of two or more colors that blend into one another. ActivePresenter gives you two gradient styles, linear and radial gradient. The linear gradient is selected by default. It makes colors change on a straight line, either horizontally, vertically, or diagonally. The gradient strip displays a sample of the gradient. It has two predefined color stops, black and white. The selected one has a blue border. You can change the color of the stop by choosing another in the theme color list. Click here to add as many color stops as you want to create different linear gradient effects. Drag the color stops along the strip to specify the selected color. Click the red minus button to remove any unwanted stop. Then, there are several ways to transform the colors. The angle option sets the angle of direction for the gradient line. As the degree increases, the gradient direction rotates clockwise. The offset X value ranges from minus 100 to 100%. It changes the position of gradient stops horizontally. The scale X option can change the width of gradient colors. When the value is 10, the width of gradient colors is minimum. And it is maximum when the value is 250. The other type of gradient fill is radial. It creates a circular progression between colors. The central color is merged into other colors that radiate from the center, either in an ellipse or in a circle. It also provides tools to adjust the colors. The offset X option is used to move the center color horizontally. The background fill is the starting color of the gradient when the value is minus 100 or 100. When the value is 0, the background fill is a blending of two colors. The offset Y option moves the center color vertically. It is moved to the top and bottom respectively when the value is minus 100 and 100. The scale X option specifies the width of the center color horizontally. It shrinks to the minimum size when the value is 10 and extends to the maximum if the value is 250. The scale Y option specifies the width of the center color vertically. Besides colors, the background fill section lets you fill a slide with images. So, you can change the slide background by choosing an image from the current project or from your file system. After that, select tile to repeat the same image throughout the background or stretch to extend the image to all edges of the slide. You still have three more options here to satisfy your needs. If you don't want to use background fill, consider background image. It's also located in the slide properties tab of the properties pane. Select an image as you do in the image fill option. This section offers you some options to change the background image position and size. At the bottom of this section, you will see two other options. Click this button to restore the original size of the selected image. Or, click Fit to Background to make the inserted image fit the background size. Besides, ActivePresenter offers an image editor to edit images right inside the app. To do that, right-click the background image, select Edit Background Image. Then, you can edit it with commands in the drawing tab. They are very common, so the editing comes naturally to you. When you're done with this process, click Save to apply the change to the current slide. After that, access the current slide to see your new background image. Another way to change the slide background is to use background styles. For further information, refer to the video How to Use Preset Background Styles. The fourth way to change slide background is by using Slide Master. This feature lets you edit slide background for multiple slides in a project, or add background graphics with ease. To do that, navigate to the View tab, click Slide Master. Then, in the Background Fill section, select one of these options to change the background. Next, click this button to apply to all slides. Note that, this will also be done if you change the background of the master layout, as the following ones inherit all the properties from the master one. For more details, refer to the video How to Use Slide Masters. Now, close the master view to check the result. That's it.